In this video, I will show you how you can improve your GoPro time-lapse videos. I will give you 5 tips to make your time-lapses look more professional. It doesn't really matter which version of the GoPro you use. And if you're new here, my name is Werner, I live in the Italian Alps, and on this channel I do tutorials and reviews on consumer cameras. At the same time, you will always see beautiful landscape shots on this channel. Consider subscribing if you're interested in these topics and have fun with this video. My first tip is about the right camera settings. I would like to show you briefly which camera settings I personally use to get the best results. When it comes to capturing a time-lapse in the best possible quality, you should choose photo as the format. That means you should create a photo time-lapse. The camera shoots single photos in a certain interval, which you can later merge into a time-lapse video. This is important because the individual photos contain much more information and can be edited much better than a video file. If you choose video as the format, the camera will create a video file that is not so well suited for editing. I would like to add that I won't go into all the settings in detail today, as there is already a video on this topic on this channel. The right interval depends a lot on what you are capturing. Basically, a time-lapse that contains a lot of motion should be captured with a shorter interval. For example, for streets or crowded places, an interval of half a second or 1 second is suitable. Since I myself mostly shoot time-lapses of landscapes and want to capture the movements of the clouds, I usually use an interval of 5 seconds. As output, I use RAW. In this case, the GoPro creates a JPEG file and a RAW file in the GPR format for each shot. RAW files usually contain more information than JPEG files and are therefore better suited for editing. However, this is not so clear with the GoPro, because the RAW files in the GPR format are hardly bigger than the JPEG files, and therefore can hardly contain much more information. What is true, however, is that the RAW files are less processed by the camera and are therefore better suited as a starting point for editing. You should also note that the GoPro RAW files can only be opened directly with Adobe programs, such as Lightroom or Camera Raw. As for Protune, I set exposure value compensation to -0.5. This prevents that very bright areas in the image burn out and no longer contain any details. The GoPro's automatic white balance actually works very well. However, if you want to prevent the GoPro from changing the white balance during a long recording, you should fix it, for example, at 5500 Kelvin for daylight shots. This way, you can edit all photos in the same way later. Then I fix the ISO at 100. That gives me the best possible image quality. Since my camera is mounted on a stable tripod anyway, also longer exposures in low light are possible without getting blurry images. And in case you are interested in tripods or other GoPro accessories, I've put some links in the video description. I set the sharpness to low to prevent the camera from adding digital sharpness to the pictures. I can do this myself later when needed. I usually leave the colors at the GoPro. The JPEG or RAW files have enough information to change the color afterwards without problems. And with that, we have already set up our GoPro perfectly. My second tip is about exposure. For an optimal time-lapse, you should fix your exposure, especially if the light conditions might change during the recording. If you don't lock the exposure, the camera will always try to change the exposure settings automatically, which can lead to unwanted results like flickering. You can fix the exposure by tapping on the display a little bit longer until a white square appears. Now you can move the square with your finger. The camera will now adjust exposure in relation to the square. Move the square to a position that leads to an optimal exposure for you. Now tap the square once more and the lock will appear. After that, you have to confirm the setting. The square and the lock will turn gray. The exposure of the camera will not change anymore and will remain fixed during the whole recording. This was the second step to a perfect time-lapse recording. For professional looking results, you should now edit the individual photos of your recording. Even if the photos that come out of the camera already look good, you can always make your photos a little more interesting when you edit them. And you'll see that you don't have to edit every single photo separately. I personally edit my photos in Adobe Lightroom. As mentioned, this program can also process the GoPro RAW files. However, most other photo editing programs are also suitable for our purpose. It's just crucial that you can apply the settings of one photo to several other photos at once. I will show you in a moment what I mean with an example. After importing the photos of my time-lapse recording, I edit the first photo. I usually take care of the white balance first, that is, whether the photo should look a little warmer or cooler. Then I look at the exposure, so whether the photo should look a little brighter or darker for a better effect. Here, I usually reduce the highlights to bring back details in the bright areas. The shadows are increased a bit to get more details in the darker areas. Please note that this is not supposed to be a complete Lightroom or editing tutorial. I just want to show you some of the possibilities that such a software offers. With Clarity, you could add a little more structure to the image. For landscapes, this can give the image a more dramatic effect. However, if I want to use the time-lapse within a longer video, I make sure that the image does not look too sharp. A cinematic video should rather have a soft look. Then I take care of the colors. Using the so-called HSL sliders, you can edit the colors individually. You can change the hue, the saturation of the individual colors, and also their luminance. Here I mainly work on the colors that are dominant in the picture. Then I often use radial filters or gradient filters and selectively edit the individual areas of the image. I mainly work on the exposure of these areas. And as you can see, we made our picture much more interesting with a few clicks. You would have a lot more options. Today, it is important to me to show you that it is possible to enhance almost every photo and therefore every time-lapse recording. Once you've finished editing the photo, you can easily apply the settings to the other photos of the time-lapse recording. To do this, select the edited photo in Lightroom together with the other photos of your recording and choose Sync Settings. Now you can choose in detail which settings should be applied to the other images. The only thing that could make things a bit more complicated is if the brightness has changed a lot during your time-lapse recording. In this case, you have to check if the exposure adjustments really work for all photos. Now we have finished editing our photos and can export them all. As mentioned, the editing process is very similar in other programs. If Lightroom, with its subscription model, is too expensive for you, I could recommend Luminar, for example. My next two tips relate to the last step of the process, which is editing your video. I use Final Cut Pro as my video editing software, but you can get the same result with other programs. After I put the edited photos on the timeline, I assign a duration of one frame to each photo. That way, we've already got a finished time-lapse. But now I want to give the shot some more depth and make it look more dynamic. Therefore, I select all photos and create a so-called compound clip. Now I can apply effects to the compound clip and not just to the individual photos. I want to add some motion to my time-lapse video and of course adjust the aspect ratio to match the aspect ratio of a 16:9 video clip. With scale, I zoom into the clip a little bit so that there are no black bars at the left and right side anymore. Now I want to zoom in a little bit during the clip. For this purpose, I create a keyframe at the beginning and scale the clip by a few percent at the end. At the same time, you could add a movement to the left or to the right and the movement up or down. To do this, you create a keyframe at the beginning again at position and then move the picture to the desired position at the end. Now you have a little more movement in your time-lapse clip. This gives the shot a lot more depth and makes it look more organic. My next tip is mainly for recordings that contain a lot of motion. On the GoPro, you don't have the possibility to control the shutter speed for time-lapse recordings, which is not really necessary in most cases. However, the camera does use a very fast shutter speed when there is sufficient light. This is basically not a big problem if your shot does not contain much motion. However, if your time-lapse recording contains a lot of movement, such as the time-lapse recording of a street or a busy place, then the movements in your clip will look very unnatural and choppy because of the lack of motion blur. The reason for this is, as already mentioned, the too fast shutter speed. Especially a time-lapse recording can benefit from motion blur to better reproduce the progression of time. On a bigger camera, for example a DSLR, you could solve the problem by setting a very slow shutter speed. On the GoPro, however, this is not possible. Most likely, you could use a very strong ND filter. However, you can also add motion blur in post. How you do this depends on your editing program. For Final Cut Pro, I have created a corresponding plugin in the form of a title. You can download it for free. You can find the link in the video description. The motion blur is available in different intensities. For this video here, I use a medium intensity. As you can see, the recording now appears more organic and can convey the progression of time much better. Now let us briefly summarize the 5 tips of this video in a few sentences. As settings on the camera, I use the photo mode, raw exposure value compensation -0.5, an ISO value of 100, sharpness low, and possibly a fixed white balance. You should fix the exposure on the LCD screen of your GoPro. You should definitely edit your photos, this way you will clearly enhance your result. Add a little more depth by adding movement to the clip in post using scale and position. Use some motion blur for time-lapse recordings with a lot of motion. This makes your recording look much more organic. And that's it for today. If the video was interesting or helpful for you, give me a like as feedback, and see you next time.